come from a country where there's a good amalgamation of different cultures, eating at so many different restaurants or meeting so many different people in Toronto is great, but I wanted to see where they come from. I wanted to experience their cultures firsthand. Once you leave Colombo and you head north or south, it is really refreshing to see the smaller towns and the smaller communities. And that's something that really resonated with me. I mean, I love my beaches. I'm totally a beach guy. As fun as Colombo can be, it's a packed city. There's also a loving, positive, open-armed attitude towards inviting guests and tourists into people's houses. I've never met so many nice people in such a small area before. Sri Lankans love their seafood, and this is especially noticeable in the south. All down the coast are busy fish markets, each filled with dozens of hardworking fishermen.
Some of these guys have been out in boats for months at a time deep in the sea, catching whatever they can. So you see an assortment of squid, shrimp, a lot of big yellowfin tuna. We watched a couple of guys bring these really big 80 kilo yellowfin tunas off a boat, just fresh catch of the day, and it was getting everyone's attention. So traders and people that want to buy the fish will point at the fish they want, a whole fish or a number of them or half a fish. They'll weigh it on the scale, then they'll put it on a bike, a packet of ice, and take it out of here. Or if they want it chopped, they'll take it to the butcher right next door to the fish stand, and he'll slice it up.
We had the opportunity to spend our afternoon with a local stilt fisherman. He invited us into his home to cook us a southern delicacy, the spicy white crab curry.
I'm very excited about this because my entry for passports and plates was the crab curry, and I'm here to now try a local version of it. The crab curry process is fairly simple, but you have to do it in the right steps. Basically, they cleaned out these blue sea crabs that the fisherman picked up in the morning, brings in the crabs, he cleans them, puts it in a pot, and into the pot goes a myriad of spices and herbs and vegetables. So we had shallots, we had tomatoes, we had dill seed powder, we had curry powder, black pepper, salt, we had a paprika type of powder as well, and we had a couple of leaves. We had a moringa leaf, a curry leaf, and to that they add some coconut milk and the coconut powder as well. So they put all this in the pot and then they cook it on an open hearth for about a half an hour. What you're left with is this creamy, white, slightly yellowish broth that's thickened down with the coconut milk, and all the spices have been absorbed by the crab. So the best way to enjoy the crab curry is to serve it with a mound of red rice or white rice. You open the crabs on top of the rice and you let the juices fall onto the rice. Cheers. I love seafood. I love my crabs and my fish and my lobsters and my shrimp. So being able to spend some time with a fisherman and taste some of that stuff and cook a meal and cook a spicy crab curry, it was definitely a highlight for me because it gave me the chance to learn a local recipe, which I will have for the rest of my life, but also a chance to spend it in someone's home. Every day we meet a new set of farmers, producers, and foodies, and they've all been so generous and meeting us with such open arms. And it's been wonderful to get a sense of local life through their eyes and through their perspectives.